Hello everyone. Here we are ready with a new chapter, a first chapter of new class, class 11, The Living World. In previous classes, we have read some basic topics of biology. That is, biology deals with the living beings, right? In ninth Indian classes, you have studied some of the basic topics of biology, including physics and chemistry also. Now, in higher classes, when you are reading hardcore biology, we are going to study all about living beings, including their cellular organization, their life processes they perform in very details, reactions takes place in their bodies, and various interactions of the organisms with other organisms and their environment. Right? We are going to study about these things in detail in class 11th and 12th and further if you study. But before going into details of living beings, the first chapter of class 11 asks you what are living beings, whom you categorize as living beings, right? So, before going into details of the living being, we need to know whom we categorize as a living being. This is the first question that you are going to discuss. So, this is living world. Now, in this chapter, you are going to discuss who are living beings. Second thing, that how you arrange all those big range of living beings present on the earth. And third point is that you are going to study how we preserve them to study it in further details. Right? That we used to do. Now, so for that there are certain characteristics, certain set of character that you have just studied in class up to in 6th and 7th you have studied that the growth you have studied other factors like living and non-living non-living or differences between living and non-living. We are going to start the chapter like this. So let's start with the first point, that is growth. In a living being, growth can be defined as increase in the number of cells and mass in an organism. That is, the number of cells and mass in an organism. So if this is increasing, that means there is growth. Right? Now, this term you are able to understand when I read these next three, four lines, then you're able to understand this definition. Growth is defined as increase in number of cell and mass. Right? All living beings grow, right? So, in living being, we consider two categories, multicellular and unicellular, right? Multi means an organisms that have, and all organisms that are having more than one cell that aggregate to form tissue, then they aggregate to form organ or organ system, all those organisms are multicellular, right? They have multiple number of cells for living a life, right? So in multicellular organism we are having two categories, plants and animals. There are other categories also, of course, fungi, fungus is also a multicellular organism, but basically we are taking these two categories, plants and animal, in multicellular organism. This is a continuous process in plants. In plants, growth is a continuous process. We have seen trees like जैसे कि हम देखते हैं नीम, पीपल, कंटिन्यूअसली यहाँ पर ग्रोथ होती रहती है, इनकी ब्रांचेस निकलती रहती है, बैनियन ट्री, इनके अंदर कंटिन्यूअस ग्रोथ होती रहती है टिल देयर लाइफ टाइम, राइट? बट इन एनिमल्स, अदर मल्टी सेलुलर ऑर्गेनिज्म ऑन अदर साइड, दिस एनिमल्स, दे ग्रोथ स्टॉप्स एट अ सर्टेन एज, दे डू नॉट ग्रो आफ्टर अ सर्टेन एज, दे डू नॉट हैव अनदर हैंड्स एंड लिम्स एट सर्टेन एज, आफ्टर सर्टेन एज, देयर इज नो इंक्रीज इन लेंथ. Right. Of course, there is increase in weight, but not length or extra organs are common. Right. At certain age, the growth stops. And in multicellular organism, all of the thing is slow process. Plants cannot grow and bear fruits and vegetables bear fruits and new leaves in one day, in one go. No, so it is a very slow process in a multicellular organism. Right. Such as plants or animals. Now just let's talk second thing in living being, that is unicellular. Unicellular organism In unicellular organisms, this process is through cell division. It is through cell division. Let's see what is that cell division. Let's take an example of a bacteria. A bacillus shaped bacteria, if it formed, it's a rough diagram, right? It can divide. You have just studied in class 10 that a bacteria can divide, right? A unicellular organism can divide into two, right? Okay, so when it divides into two, you can see that there is a one cell, right? There is a one cell, and now there are two cells, right? So if number of cell increases, right? Number of cell increases. So when number of cell increases, there is growth. In unicellular organism, growth is by increasing number of cells, by cell division. And mass in an organism increases. In plants and in animals, mass of an organism increases. That is in term of growth. So all living being grow, right? Any non-living can also grow. Yes, there are some factors that we can see. तो हमें छलावे की तरह कहता है कि ग्रोथ है, right? You can see, you have heard it at different times that the length of a mountain is increasing continuously, हिमालय is increasing और या फिर वो धसक रहा है, पहाड़ आगे से हिल आगे आ रहा है, right? Boundary cross कर रहा है, so that is mountain. Size of the mountain is also increasing. You have most of the time like if you have ever been in a kind of deserts or sands. You can see that the particle of the sands, their size will increase whenever there is wind, because those particles get aggregated or accumulated by many other particles. So mound of sand on mountain, they also increases, but that is only external. But there is a increase in mass, there is increase in size, so there is a growth, right? Either it is external, but there is growth. So how we can say this factor is exclusive to living being, that only living being can grow and growth is an factor? So this is the question mark, right? The next part that we have ever read, that all living being reproduce, right? If they are living being, they will reproduce. That means that is a basic character, one of the basic character. Let's see. Its definition itself lies in the term reproduction. Means again, production means producing something again, right? So it is a process of production of young ones more or less alike to their parents. If so, parents aise young ones produce karte hain, aise cheeze produce karte hain, to unhi ke jaise dikhti hai. So this is reproduction, right? Again, in living being we will talk multi and unicellular. So how multicellular reproduce? Multicellular reproduce by a complex process called as sexual reproduction, right? What is sexual reproduction? Why it is called as complex? Complex to care and for sexual reproduction hai kya? Many times heard that, I am drawing a symbols here. That when male and female pairing, so this is female, and this is the sign for male. When male and female parent it will take little time, right? Male and female parent produces gametes, right? It produces gametes. Gametes such as you can see egg. Female produces egg and male produces sperm, right? Okay, egg and sperm, and these gametes, so these are gametes, when they fuse, they will form, fuse to form together a zygote. A single cell zygote, okay? And that zygote further grow in the form of baby. Alright, this is what called as this is what called as reproduction by sexual mode. So it is a very complex process. Both the parents will form the gametes. They fuse, they form zygote, and then it is going to form a baby, right? Baby. Okay. Either male or female. So multicellular organism reproduces by a process called a sexual reproduction. That is a very complex process. But what happens in a unicellular organism, because they have single cell, they reproduce through a very simpler process. A single cell hai, toh simpler process hogi, bahut simple hogi, by a sexual reproduction. That is, they have only single cell, right? And that single parent will give rise to one or more next generation, one or more young one, right? Single parent. वहाँ पर यहाँ पर दो parent है sexual में और वहाँ पे single होंगे. तो एक simple example ले लेते हैं यहाँ पे. जैसे कि ये हमारा है, right? This is a bacteria, unicellular bacteria. It will divide. And after dividing, it will form two cells. But ये तो growth थी ना? जी. अगर ये parent cell इसको हम मान लें, और क्योंकि ये parent cell है, और ये parent cell divide हो रहा है, तो ये क्या बना रहा है? दो daughter cells, right? तो parent cell divide होने के बाद दो daughter cell बना रहा है. This is asexual reproduction. Single parent cell will give rise to the next generation or the new young ones. In unicellular organism, this reproduction is synonymous, मतलब समानार्थक है, to growth and just by a single cell division. It takes place, right? It will form a next generation. Now, what is the exception here? Right? अभी मैंने आपको growth में एक exception बताई. यहाँ पर भी एक exception है. We are not talking about non-living being. Non-living being do not reproduce. Right? That is the fact. If it is non-living being, it will not reproduce. ऐसा नहीं होता है कि मेरी एक chair है उसके साथ दो छोटी chair है तो chair के वो बच्चे हैं. नहीं, ऐसा नहीं है. So non-living can not reproduce. But what about those living organisms that can't reproduce? There are some anomalies that some of the living organisms cannot reproduce. So they are not living. If they are not reproducing, they are not living. They are, right? No, so there are some interesting examples. Number one is sterile worker bee, right? Worker bee. You have seen, आपको पता है कि bee के तीन categories होते हैं, right? Let's see these categories. There is a male drone that is called as drone. This is a symbol for male, right? That is a symbol for male. So a male bee that is called as drone. Bee for drone. It will produce gametes and will fuse with a female bee that is known as queen bee, right? It will produce gametes and they both reproduce and form another baby or bee, right? Okay. बनाएंगे ऑफ कोर्स दे विल प्रोड्यूस अ बी राइट बट देयर इज अनदर काइंड ऑफ बी अदर देन ड्रोन एंड क्वीन बी देयर इज अनदर फीमेल बीज दैट आर अनदर फीमेल बीज दैट आर वर्कर बी राइट दीज वर्कर बी विल नॉट टेक पार्ट दीज वर्कर बी विल नॉट टेक पार्ट इन रिप्रोडक्शन देयर फंक्शन इज ओनली टू गैदर द हनी For the proper functioning of the other bees that are taking part in reproduction. They are sterile. They are not producing any of the offspring, any of the next generation. They are not producing. So they are sterile. Infertile couple. You have heard in human beings, those couples that cannot reproduce are called as infertile. Due to many medical terms, they cannot reproduce. That are called as infertile couples. Second part, and there is another thing is mule. Mule is a living species that looks like in between donkey and horse, because it is formed by the fusion of gametes of donkey and horse. So it is a species formed by parents such as donkey and horse, by fusion of donkey and horse. this is mule. So it is unable to reproduce it is unable to reproduce to form next mule generation. So it is also sterile. Third is metabolism. Right? Third is metabolism. What is metabolism? You have, I guess this is one of the new terms that in class 11th you are reading, that is metabolism. Metabolism is the sum total of all reactions taking place in the body. So, previously you have seen that reactions taking place inside the test tube, in the book you have seen many of the reactions have been written in chemistry, right? But there are many reactions that also take place inside your body. Your body is also a kind of laboratory. There are many reactions taking place inside that. So, sum total of all those reactions taking place in the body is called as metabolism. Right? These reactions are of two types. Number one, catabolism, and the second one, anabolism. Number one, catabolism is the process of breakdown. All those reactions in which breakdown of substances takes place is known as catabolism. So, such as you have heard digestion, right? In digestion, complex food product will divide into small, simpler products so that we can get energy from our food. So, catabolism is a type of metabolism in which breakdown of food takes place, breakdown of anything takes place. An example, Kafka digestion. Anabolism, a type of metabolism or in which some of all reaction in which formation or making of substances takes place. So formation or making you can see very common example is photosynthesis. Right, photosynthesis. So in photosynthesis, plants in the presence of light will form their food, right? So formation ho gaya aapko, anabolism, photosynthesis. In catabolism, there is another example also, respiration, that is after part of course, digestion ka complete part, respiration, right? So, ye bhi ek part hai, respiration and digestion, and anabolism, example, photosynthesis. These all reactions can also take place outside the body. It's not that ki body mein hoti hai, kuch simpler form mein. Hum ye test tube mein bhi karwa sakte hai. And yes, this is a new term for you. अगर ये बात हम टेस्ट ट्यूब के लिए कर रहे हैं तो हम इन विट्रो लिख रहे हैं, राइट? अगर बॉडी के अंदर होता तो हम एक नया टर्म यूज करते, वो मैं अभी आपको बताऊंगी, ठीक है? तो ये जो सारी की सारी रिएक्शन है वो टेस्ट ट्यूब में भी हो सकती है. दिस इज कॉल्ड एज लिविंग रिएक्शन. दीज ऑल रिएक्शन व्हेन टेक प्लेस इन द टेस्ट ट्यूब इट इज नोन एज लिविंग रिएक्शन. बट वी कैन नॉट सी दीज ऑल रिएक्शन outside the body, right? अगर हम करवा रहे हैं test tube में तो ठीक है, but अगर कोई living being बहुत सारे reactions body के अंदर कर ही रहा है तो क्या हमें पता चलेगा कि वो reactions हो रही है body के अंदर, right? We don't know, right? तो अगर नहीं पता चल रहा है तो क्या वो living being नहीं है? We cannot say yes or no. Of course, no. If it is a living being, it have another characteristic also if we are not able to see metabolism. Fourth one is self-consciousness. So in Hindi, this term is more familiar, chetna, jise hum kehte hain. What is self-consciousness? This is the ability to sense, and after sensing, respond to surroundings. Whenever there is an external factor acting on you, कोई भी surrounding external factor है, जैसे कि ठंड शुरू हो गई अचानक से, right? तो अचानक से बर्फ पड़ रही है कहीं पे, अचानक से ठंड शुरू हो गई, you will respond, right? अगर कहीं अचानक से अर्थक्वेक आया है, राइट, सराउंडिंग में अचानक से ट्रेमर्स उठे और अर्थक्वेक आया, आप रिस्पॉन्ड करेंगे, आप जल्दी से उठेंगे और भागेंगे, राइट? दैट मींस यू हैव कॉन्शियस, यू आर रिस्पॉन्डिंग टुवर्ड्स इट, राइट? दिस इज नोन एज चेतना और सेल्फ कॉन्शियसनेस. एंड नो लिविंग बींग कैन रिस्पॉन्ड टुवर्ड्स एन एनवायरमेंटल, सॉरी, नो नॉन लिविंग बींग, आई हैव टू ऐड, नो नॉन लिविंग बींग, राइट? No non-living being can respond towards an environmental condition. Hence, it is most deciding factor that anybody can be considered living or not. So, any non-living being agar hai, तो वो रिस्पॉन्ड नहीं कर सकता। अगर कोई पत्थर है बहुत तेज हवा चली, सिर्फ हवा के दबाव से उड़ सकता है, अपने आप नहीं हटेगा। अगर गाड़ी के आगे आपके कोई सामान रखा हुआ है, वो सामान खुद तो नहीं हिलेगा, तो वो नॉन लिविंग है, राइट? तो उसके अंदर ऐसी कोई चेतना नहीं है, पर आपके अगर सामने गाड़ी आ जाती है, आप हिलेंगे, राइट? आप खड़े नहीं रहेंगे। देयर इज ऑल्सो एन एक्सेप्शन फॉर दैट सेल्फ कॉन्शियसनेस। वट अबाउट अ पेशेंट दैट इज इन कोमा, राइट? और हिज हर लाइफ इज सपोर्टेड बाय अ मशीन। क्या इनके साथ सेम केस होगा जब अर्थक्वेक आएगा या आग लगेगी? विल दे एबल टू मूव? अगर वो ब्रेन डेड है या फिर दे आर सपोर्टेड ऑन अ वेंटिलेटर, इज आर दे एबल टू मूव? सो डू दे लॉस द सेल्फ कॉन्शियसनेस? देयर बॉडी इज परफॉर्मिंग मेनी रिएक्शन इनसाइड, बट दे आर अनएबल टू कनेक्ट टू द ब्रेन एंड आस्किंग इट फॉर एन एनी एक्शन, सो दे आर अनएबल टू रिस्पॉन्ड। उनका ब्रेन कनेक्टेड नहीं है, बहुत सारे ऑर्गन ब्रेन से कनेक्टेड नहीं है, इसलिए वो ऑर्गन मूव नहीं करेंगे, राइट? वो ऑर्गन ब्रेन को नहीं पूछ सकते कि रिस्पॉन्ड करना है या नहीं करना, बिकॉज दे आर नॉट कनेक्टेड ड्यू टू सम रीजंस, दे आर नॉट कनेक्टेड। सो दे आर सपोर्टेड बाय मशीन, दे आर इन कोमा, दे आर नॉट एबल टू रिस्पॉन्ड। सो आर दे नॉट लिविंग बीइंग? दे आर। सो वट एवर वी हैव जस्ट डिस्कस्ड एंड even read so far in the smaller classes, growth, reproduction, metabolism, self-consciousness, all these four categories are unable to define a living being alone, right? Most of all, of course, self-consciousness do this thing, but ye charo ke charo akele nahi bata sakte ki living being kaun hai. But when we gather all those things, overall discussion jab hum ek saath kar lete hain, to living being ki definite definition of course hame milti hai. What are living beings? Living beings are self-replicating, right? That means they are able to form their another copy, that is, they are able to form their young ones, right? Evolving, they can continuously change as the environment changes. जैसे जैसे environment change होगा उस हिसाब से वो adapt होते जाएंगे, right? आप पहले पहले जब पहाड़ पे चढ़ते हैं तो आपको बहुत सांस चढ़ती है, फिर आप continuous हो जाते हैं तो आपको आसान हो जाता है। जब बहुत छोटे होते हैं तो डर लगता है झूले पे चढ़ने से, लेकिन फिर जब आप धीरे धीरे वही काम रोज करते हैं तो आप इवॉल्व हो जाते हैं, राइट? देन सेल्फ रेगुलेटिंग, राइट? सेल्फ रेगुलेटिंग, देयर मेनी रिएक्शंस टेक्स प्लेस इनसाइड द बॉडी एंड वी आर एबल टू रेगुलेट। अगर टेम्परेचर बहुत ठंड है तो भी हमारी बॉडी का टेम्परेचर कॉन्स्टेंट रहेगा, अगर बहुत ज्यादा गर्मी है तो भी हम कॉन्स्टेंट रहेंगे, राइट? इंटरैक्टिव सिस्टम्स, राइट? इंटरैक्टिव सेल्फ रेगुलेटिंग एंड इंटरैक्टिव, we are a system which can interact with other living beings and surrounding. हम खुद एक अपने अंदर एक सिस्टम है जो इंटरैक्ट कर सकता है, right? Within our body, outside the body with other organism and in the environment, we can interact for food, for many other needs, for reproduction, for many other needs we use to interact. That are capable of responding to external stimuli. These living beings are able to respond to external stimuli. जिनके सारे के सारे कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स वी आर एबल टू फाइंड इन अ बीइंग इन एनी ऑफ द ऑर्गेनाइजम, देन दैट ऑर्गेनाइजम विल बी कॉल्ड अ लिविंग, राइट? दिस इज लिविंग बीइंग, राइट? सो दिस इज ऑल अबाउट हु आर लिविंग, राइट? दिस इज अवर फर्स्ट सेशन, इन दैट वी हैव जस्ट डिस्कस्ड हु आर लिविंग बीइंग, सो दैट वी आर एबल टू डिस्कस मोर फर्दर थिंग्स अबाउट लिविंग वर्ल्ड, राइट? नेक्स्ट पार्ट इज द diversity in living beings, or we can say biodiversity, and how we conserve that, we will do in the next session, next class. So thank you.